Hi ladies and gentlemen, good morning or good evening to everyone. Today I am going to discuss NDM file transfer concept in mainframe and what are differences between FTP and NDM. NDM full form is Network Data Mover. It is a computer software product that transfer files between mainframe computer servers or any other computer servers. NDM was renamed as Connect Direct in 1993 at System Center Company, and this is a mainframe screen. If you will press here NDM, you will be switched to this kind of screen, and it is IBM Sterling Connect Direct. But why we say it IBM Sterling? Because Connect Direct was renamed NDM was renamed at System Center in 1993, and that System Center was acquired. System Center company was acquired by the Sterling Software Company, and then Sterling Software Company has created its own entity named as Sterling Commerce. And it actually monitor the marketing of the communication and file transfer processing. And after that, SBC Communication has acquired the Sterling Commerce in 2000 year. And after that, in 2005, it was merged with the AT&T company. Okay, and after that, IBM has acquired the Sterling software product from the AT&T company. Okay, and that's why it is named as IBM Sterling. If you want to go further in this NDM processing, you need to enter your user ID and then password. After pressing password and enter, you will go to the next screen. Then if you want to see if your file is successfully transferred or not, then you need to press SS in the option. Like it will show the statistic for a completed process. Okay, and this is job name. Means I have submitted one job and it is spool of that job, like T091TST, and there is Connect Direct. Okay, login is successful. If you say sign on is successful, and then submit DSN, we have submitted this DSN and 091WGD, and this is the process number 10400. This process number we need to enter in the NDM. Here we need to enter this process number and when we have submitted the job, like today, yesterday, or any specific date you can enter. And here you need to press summary table to display the summary of the process. Like if you will see here, there is like copy, okay, and there is like node name, like N091WGD, and then there is server name, okay, through which we receive the file. Okay, and after that, if you will press S here, you will see the next screen. If there is any error in the transferring, so you will see here star. You will see here star, like it is also written in the down. And after pressing S, you will see like copy step successfully, means this file is copied successfully, and all the record like has been transferred 12,384 to the destination, and this is named with the file is named with the this data set, and like this number of byte has been successfully transferred. Okay, and this is server name from which we received the file, and okay, and like we have used this step 2, or you can say step 1. Okay, and we have used this proc four utility, you can say utility four J4 BF NDM. Okay, and then we are using this card member C091W80, and this card contain the sign on in the NDM node NDM21, and then submit this DSN. Okay, then after submitting this, after processing completing or processing, you can sign off the NDM. And this NDM card contain the like step one, okay, and it will copy the data from this server S node to the P node. Okay, means our P node is our mainframe server. So it will copy to the mainframe this file from this file at this location. And it like LRECL will be this, and its format will be VB. So it will be like that. And you need to give like S node ID also, your through which you are submitting, and P accounting and S node accounting, you need to give this all. And after that, you can check the step one is completed successfully or not. If it is like zero, then like we need to submit this greater than zero, otherwise go to the step two. In step two, we are copying this file from the S node to the P node with this data set in the mainframe. And if it is successful, then run this, otherwise exit. And now what are differences between NDM and FTP? NDM offers for logging, audit and control feature automatically. But FTP doesn't have the elaborate process for logging and auditing. Means this is like our FTP step. So you need to first use the FTP utility or protocol. Then you need to log in to this server, and then you need to give user ID and password as well, and then you need to go to the directory and what kind of file you want to create on the mainframe, and then get this file from the destination to you from the destination to your, so wherever you want this file in this data set form. Okay, so you need to give all user ID and password. And NDM is great resource to use when dealing with large data packet. Okay, and FTP require through follow up process for file transfer and download. Means there are loads of processing need to be done, like we need to give user ID and password each time. Okay, and data security is guaranteed with NDM, which offer encryption. Okay, and FTP has encryption option, but desired for improved data security. NDM compresses the data and therefore use a low bandwidth. And FTP doesn't compress data and use a higher bandwidth. The checkpoint start feature is offered in NDM only. And checkpoint start means if like your file transfer is failed at some point, so in NDM it will start from that point only. Means it will not start over from the beginning. Okay, it will start from that point only. And FTP doesn't allow for the checkpoint restart. And NDM offer pre and post processing feature. Okay, and means you have transferred the file, you will after that you will see the in NDM tool what is the process number and how many bytes it is transferred. And FTP only has the post processing feature. Okay, and thank you guys, that's all from my side. Please like the video and hit the subscribe button.